The global economy has not had a good year, to put it mildly. Trade war uncertainty and Chinese weakness have taken a heavy toll, with growth in 2019 set to be the worst since the financial crisis, according to the International Monetary Fund.Such an environment has produced many doomsters and gloomsters, to use Boris Johnson's phrase. But there are few in finance as gloomy as Donald Amstad, head of Asian investment specialists at Aberdeen Standard Investments.Read more, Bank of England, trade wars and Brexit deal will limit growth in a video from August that, by the financial world's standards, went viral with 700,000 views. Amstad argued that the developed world is on the brink of an economic and political crisis that its policymakers are poorly placed to tackle. One of Amstad's chief concerns is that central banks in developed economies are very close to being out of bullets, he tells me. Having saturated markets with printed money and slashed interest rates, in some cases to below zero, meaning investors pay to lend, there seems to be little left in the arsenal with which to slay the next downturn. A major question is whether interest rates can go much lower than zero without serious distortions. Minus 1% may be possible, but I'm not sure you can go to minus 10, Amstad says. Yet some see things another way, arguing that rate setters have innovated before and will do again. Danae Kyriakopoulou, chief economist at central bank forum Omfif, says, throughout the crisis central bank toolboxes have been strengthened, they have more powers now. Many policymakers and pundits say negative interest rates and other ultra-unorthodox policies are already a problem, which are now worsening the slowdown rather than soothing it. Read more, IMF says 2019 global growth to be lowest since financial crisis. Amstad sees merit in this argument. I give the example of my mother. God bless her, who's not earning any money on her savings in the bank and therefore feels that she has to economize, he says. Across an economy, such attitudes damped growth. The chief executives of Deutsche Bank and UBS have said European lenders are also suffering under the policy. With rates so low, there is little money to be made from the interest margin, they say. Part of the problem for the economy, Amstad argues, is that central banks' money printing schemes have not gone to plan. The idea was that firms would invest the cheap money they were handed, kickstarting the economy. Instead, they've used this as an opportunity either to pay special dividends or to buy back stock, Amstad says. Then we've had a sustained period of austerity. What can be done to wean the world off central banks' cheap money and boost growth? Absent a US-China trade deal, one increasingly talked about solution is government spending. But this route runs into a major obstacle. Amstad says, a bubble and tea. For more on this story, visit the news article link.